going to skip introductions today and go straight to today's video topic because this is a serious one. So first of all, the individual we are going to be talking about today is Dakota Reynolds, as YouTube present him as Dakota Reynolds, the greatest experimental creation. Note that some words that will be stated here are part of the Google Doc made by Harris and the victims. You might have questions, but I'll take it from the top for better understanding on the situation. So it all started when someone named Harris reached out to me recently regarding this situation, and I decided to look into it and saw quite a whole lot with evidences. Dakota is allegedly a 22 to 23-year-old man who has been targeting minors in the community, and has been exposed for engaging in predatory behavior with minors in the community for over 2 to 3 years now, and is interested in role-playing with children. Around 2022, Dakota created a private Discord chat where he asks minors to join by tagging them on his community post. He pressures them to send pictures of their privates and also engage in weird NSFW role plays with those minors, which to me is sick. And what is more alarming is that this is still ongoing, as there are more recent screenshots as well, where he attempts to engage in sensual role plays and also requested for the minor to add him on Discord for private conversations. And when the individual's channel was inspected, it turns out that their channel description stated that they're 15, not yet an adult. Additionally, Dakota has been recently and repeatedly tagging YouTube channels owned by minors on his community posts in an attempt to add them on his Discord. And for the ones who blocked him, he is seen trying to use manipulative and guilt-tripping tactics to make them feel guilty of blocking him while requesting friendship with them again. This behavior is quite disturbing. I got to reach out to some of his victims who spoke up about the experience they had with Dakota, and with the help of Harris, a former friend of Dakota and the individual who reached out to me regarding this situation. Evidence shows that one of Dakota's main victims, Andy, blocked him after he asked her for explicit photos and attempted to engage in inappropriate roleplay with her. Following that, he has persistently guilt-tripped her, using various tactics to pressure her into unblocking him and resuming communication. And here is evidence of Dakota admitting that he asked Andy for explicit photos. And another one of Dakota's victims named Phantom, who opened up about his experience with Dakota, stated that he was 12, about turning 13 at the time of these happenings about 2 years ago. He made an 8 minutes long voice recording, which I'll be summarizing. Apparently, Phantom was having a conversation with his friends in the server. Then, when Dakota came in and made a silly joke which left Phantom in question and wondering what Dakota was talking about, and Phantom decided to ask Dakota in his DMs to clear his curiosity. With time, Phantom started noticing how Dakota would flirt with him in an explicit roleplay fashion, and at some point, Phantom asked Dakota for his gender, to which Dakota lied and claimed to be a female. As time passes, Dakota begins to ask Phantom for pictures of his privates, which made Phantom extremely uncomfortable and to which Phantom refused. Dakota ended up begging, telling Phantom that he could also show his own private pics to him, and Phantom still refused, stating that he is not interested in seeing it. A situation led to Dakota revealing that he was a guy, and Phantom got confused and weirded out when he found out. Couple of months went by, Phantom found out that some individuals who were apparently gacha tubers as well, were sending pictures of their privates to Dakota, since Dakota sent them to him and told him his thoughts about it, which made Phantom uncomfortable and he wished he didn't experience all these with Dakota. Dakota also made a gacha heat of his OC with Phantom's OC and lied about his age and gender to Phantom, but was later exposed by Phantom's friends. Bear in mind that Phantom was only 12 years old and Dakota was allegedly 20 to 21 as at the time. Another awful thing Dakota did was to falsely accuse one of Harris's friends named Marvik, who was at the time doing his best to stop Dakota's awful actions. Dakota said that Marvik was actually the one responsible for those actions and reached out to a gacha rander at that time. As a result of that accusation, the rander posted a 1-hour video on YouTube, falsely accusing Marvik of things he never did and ruining Marvik's reputation. The fact that Marvik was just 14 years old and falsely accused of being a PDF file, but it was later revealed that Marvik was innocent and had no hands in it. And here shows evidence of another gacha YouTuber and a friend of Dakota named Galaxy Princess, who is supposedly an adult and is deeply responsible for the harm in this situation. She chose to support Dakota's actions instead of stopping him and taking sides with the victims. She has been defending Dakota Reynolds, despite the clear evidence of his predatory behavior and despite having a clear knowledge of his horrible actions. She has made attempts to downplay his actions and even excused his manipulation and harassment. The most shocking part is when she claims she wouldn't care if someone sexually harassed her brother, just because she didn't get along with her brother. This shows a disturbing lack of empathy and an inability to understand the damage Dakota has caused, especially to minors, by defending him. Galaxy has made it harder for the victims, showing that she's more focused on protecting Dakota than acknowledging the harm he's done. Here are evidence where Dakota claimed that it is okay for an adult to engage in NSFW roleplays with minors, stating that it's not illegal and it's just a roleplay. When Dakota faces confrontation regarding his actions, he responded with threats, claims he is falsely accused and denial, and the most shocking and enraging part in all of this is when Dakota stated that autism made him do it. Dakota excuses his inappropriate actions and predatory behaviors by using autism and ADHD as an excuse. He's using autism as a shield despite not have a clear understanding of the mental health condition, which is wrong. Flatulendi made a video about it, which I recommend you go watch. It's insane how he blames autism for making him act like a creep and showcase predatory behaviors. This is sickening how he refused to take accountability and puts the blame on a disorder. In conclusion to this, this person is someone you should watch out for, as they display harmful behaviors and they don't deserve a platform with this kind of behavior, as they are a danger to minors in the community. Do not harass them or send threats. My aim is to simply bring this to the public's awareness and not meant for you to go harassing them. If anyone chooses to reach out to him, it should be with the goal of helping him understand the severity of his actions and encouraging him to change. Our priority should be supporting the victims, keeping the community safe, and holding him accountable without causing further harm. And to minors in the community, be sure to stay away from creeps like these and stay safe out there.